Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. The afternoon concert. Today, during this period, we shall broadcast a rehearsal by the Minneapolis Symphony Orchestra. Our program comes direct from the stage of Northrop Memorial Auditorium here on the campus of the University of Minnesota, where the orchestra is working on the Symphony No. 1 by Arthur Schnabel, which will receive its world premiere at tomorrow evening's concert. Here is Dimitri Metropoulos, who will tell us something about this music and who will then conduct the orchestra in this broadcast rehearsal.
Good afternoon, friends of music, friends of the orchestra, and friends of mine. As you remember, a year ago, almost at the same period, we gave you another broadcasted rehearsal, and that was for another important piece and difficult that we had a hard time to prepare. That was the concerto for violin by Schoenberg that Mr. Louis Krasner so heroically played. This year, our highest point of the season, or climax, let us say, and I mean that because we really work since the beginning of the season, saving time every week and going through that difficult work, rehearsing with courage and patience. Finally, we arrived to a quite satisfactory result, which we are going to give you today. I really consider that, I introduced that already from last year, that every year we are going to try to climb our mountain, the mountain, the climax of the season. I always see, I'm always speaking on mountaineering terms because, first of all, I love mountains, and I think that it's a wonderful symbol for our life philosophy. Each time we try to climb a mountain, and if we come down from the mountain, it's only because we are going to climb some other mountain. So we constantly climb until we die. And that is also in art, the crescendos, the diminuendos, the forte piano subitos, which means a sudden piano, like a sudden cliff after you arrive at the summit of the mountain, and so on. Our life is a constant, at least the real life, the life of those who are born for achievements. It's a constant crescendo, a constant climbing and declining for reclining, and so on. So, our climbing this afternoon, or this year, this season, is the achievement of having prepared this difficult piece of music, the First Symphony by Arthur Schnabel. You all know him as a great pianist, but you never heard him yet as a composer. I do think that we all here are proud to have achieved that as best as we could. And this morning, I really thank my voice from the bottom of my heart for having helped me to climb that last pinnacle of that musical mountain, which is the symphony by Mr. Schnapp. Now we are going on playing the world piece, and we hope that you will be able to enjoy it and also maybe to understand it better by hearing it tomorrow once more. It's a pity that we have always to finish our job after a performance. All the preparation goes out after the performance. Doesn't stay anymore. But just the same, as I told you, that doesn't matter. It doesn't matter for a masterpiece if it isn't played often. It's even better, because that keeps its freshness, and it doesn't get spoiled by being overplayed. But anyway, we are not resentful, and we are not bitter about that fate of ours, because we know that we will have to climb some other mountain. So that's all I had to say. The symphony in itself is not as difficult in comprehension as it was the Schoenberg concerto we played last year. It's more romantic, it's more on the melodic side, but certainly it's quite a tough piece to understand, and we will try to give you the best we can We worked hard on it to make it as clear as possible. So now on with the performance.
Thank you.
afternoon concert today has featured a rehearsal by the Minneapolis Symphony Orchestra of the Symphony No. 1 of Arthur Schnabel, which receives its world premiere at tomorrow evening's concert and which was broadcast for the first time anywhere on this program. During this special program, you heard also from our conductor, Dimitri Mitropoulos, who made comments on this music, especially for the radio audience. As you know, the public is very rarely permitted to attend a symphony orchestra rehearsal, and few of them are broadcast. This afternoon's program was arranged in order to prepare symphony goers for this rather unusual Schnabel symphony, which is scheduled for tomorrow's concert. Would you like to hear more broadcasts of this sort? We hope you will write or call us at KUOM to give us your answer. This is the University of Minnesota radio station, KUOM, St. Paul, Minneapolis.